Hi, welcome to the glass plate. In today's example, we're going to consider a glass of tea in which you put some sugar. The tea height in your cup, H, is on the order of 10 centimeters. We're going to estimate when sugar will start appearing here at the top, and we do that for the case when there is no stirring. You just wait. So this stuff will start moving upwards. It will diffuse into your tea. Diffusion coefficient is 6 times 10 to the minus 9 meters squared per second for a temperature of about 70 degrees Celsius. If you do this at room temperature, then the diffusion coefficient is roughly 3 times as small. So we need to know when the sugar arrives. Not exactly. An estimate will do. Let's review our situation. This is diffusion. It is definitely unsteady, as first there is no sugar and then sugar comes in. The geometry is a plate. We need to answer, is this long or short times? Well, initially, this is your T ending somewhere here, and this is where the sugar is sitting. And the concentration will do something like this until you reach the end. So in the beginning, this is just penetration theory with the penetration depth slowly moving in. And what we will do is see when the penetration depth is so far that it reaches the end, so that the sugar has diffused there. So we say, well, this time is something on the order that the height over which diffusion has to take place becomes equal on the order of the penetration depth. Then you reach the end and then you start noticing sugar here. Thus, T equals, in this estimate, H squared over pi. D, with H 10 centimeter, and D given by this number, is going to be a very long time. Something like 150 hours. Surely enough, by that time your tea will be cold and undrinkable. In practice, everybody stirs. And in practice, it's not this bad. Because we assume that it's only diffusion if we don't stir. But that's not completely true. This tea, which is hot, warm, compared to the surroundings, will cool down, especially at the free surface where a little bit of your water evaporates. That means that this tea here will cool down fastest, as only here evaporation takes place. Well, tea, basically water, if the temperature goes down, then the density of the water goes up. Now the density of this part is high, and gravity will pull it down, replacing it by something from the bottom that is still hot and has still a low density. So you see that gravity will induce flow, which is called natural convection. And that automatically kicks in. You don't have to stir. This will always be the case in your cup of tea. And this stirring by gravity obviously make that the time required for sugar to come here at the top is much, much lower. That's beyond what we'll do. This is just an illustration of how you can use penetration theory, provided your system is diffusion only. And the catch here is, it's not diffusion only.